हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर पवन जगन्नाथ तांबड़े, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन केमिस्ट्री एट मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाज नाशिक। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी द कंसेप्ट ऑफ सीस ट्रांस आइसोमेरिज्म। डियर फ्रेंड, सीस ट्रांस आइसोमर्स आर नथिंग बट अ टाइप ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म। ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमर्स आर द स्टीरियो आइसोमर्स which are having same bond connectivity but do not show non-superimposable mirror image relationship. Such molecules are called as cis trans isomers of each other. This cis trans isomerism can be observed in case of alkenes, cycloalkenes and in case of cycloalkanes. So we will explore cis trans isomerism in all these three cases. In case of alkene, cis and trans isomers are possible because the double bond present in alkene is rigid. The double bond cannot rotate, and thus the atoms or group across double bond are in fixed position. For example, if you consider the example of 2-butene, in case of 2-butene, these two different types of arrangements of atom or group across this carbon-carbon double bonds are possible. Either these two CH3 groups are on same side or these two CH3 groups are on opposite side, and depending upon their positions, in case of 2-butene or alkenes like this, cis trans isomerism is possible. It is not possible to rotate this carbon-carbon double bond, and because of that, position of this atom or group across double bond is always fixed. And thus, isomerism arises in case of alkenes. In case of alkenes, cis trans isomers occurs when different groups are attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. In case of cis isomer, groups attach on the same side of the double bond, and in case of trans isomer, the groups are attached on opposite side of the double bond. If similar atoms or groups are attached on same carbon atom in case of alkene, then such structure do not show cis trans isomerism. So these are some conditions which we need to observe in cis trans isomers. You will see certain examples, and from those examples it will become clear that which kind of alkenes will show cis trans isomerism and which do not. If you look at this type of alkenes, say for example, in this case there are four similar atoms or group attached to this carbon-carbon double bond. In this case, two different types of atoms or groups are there, but there is one atom or group of type A and other atoms or group of type B. And in third case, two different types of atoms or groups are attached to carbon-carbon double bond, but on one carbon atom, two similar atoms or groups are there, and on another carbon atom, two similar atoms or groups are there. In these three cases, these type of alkenes do not show cis trans isomerism. However, if suppose we are having this type of condition where these two different types of atoms or groups are attached across this carbon-carbon double bond, and each carbon atom is having two different atoms or groups to it. If you look at this structure and this structure, you will find that they are isomers of each other. But in this case, both AA are attached to same carbon or BB attached to same carbon. However, in this case, on one carbon A and B is there, and on another carbon A and B is there. And if you look at relative positions of A and A or B and B across carbon-carbon double bond, you will find that in this case, this A and A is on same side and B are on same side. In the same way, if you look at this structure, which is again isomer of above structure, then in this case A and A are on opposite side and B are on opposite side. So this molecule shows cis trans isomers. In this case, as these similar groups are on same side, this molecule is called as cis isomer. And in this case, similar atoms or groups are on opposite side, so this is called as trans isomers. So this type of molecules shows cis trans isomerism. Now suppose if we are having this type of structure where three different types of atoms or group are attached to four positions of carbon-carbon double bond, then in this case also, depending upon relative positions of similar atom on different carbon atom, we can have cis trans isomerism. For example, if these similar atoms or group, say A and A, which are present on two different carbon atoms, are on same side, then such molecule is called as cis isomer. However, if this A and A is present on two different carbon atom of alkene are on opposite side to each other, then such structure is called as trans isomer of that particular alkene. Now suppose if four different atoms or groups are attached to this carbon-carbon double bond of alkene, then in this case again cis trans isomerism is not possible. However, in certain cases we can claim a relative cis trans isomerism, that is C is trans to A or D is cis to A and so on. But this is not the real cis trans isomerism. We can call it as a relative cis trans isomerism. So these are the conditions in which cis trans isomerism can occur. Now we will see certain examples. Dear friends, if molecule shows cis trans isomerism, then the prefixes cis or trans are placed in front of the name of that particular alkene. Say for example, if we are having 2-butene, and in case of 2-butene, these two different arrangements are possible. Either these two CH3 groups are on same side or they may be on opposite side. If these two similar groups or atoms are on same side, then such molecule is cis isomer. And if they are on opposite side, then the molecule is trans isomer. While writing name of such alkene, we will write down the prefix cis or trans before their name. This molecule is named as cis-2-butene and this molecule is named as trans-2-butene. Now we will explore certain examples. Look at this molecule. This molecule, across this carbon-carbon double bond, two different types of atoms or groups are attached to same carbon atom, COOH and hydrogen. And depending upon their relative position, we are having two different types of these alkenes. In this case, these two carboxylic acid group or hydrogens are present on same side of double bond. So this is cis isomer. Name of this molecule is maleic acid. And if you look at this next structure, in this case, position of this COOH and hydrogen across carbon-carbon double bond is opposite to each other. So this is trans isomer. This molecule name as fumaric acid. So these two are nothing but geometrical isomers, that is stereoisomers of each other, in which bond connectivity is same but arrangement of atom or group across carbon-carbon double bond is different. This is cis isomer and this one is trans isomer. In the same way, if you look at these three hexene molecules, then in case of three hexene, these two different arrangements are possible. These ethyl groups are present across carbon-carbon double bond and their relative position may be they are on same side or they may be on opposite side. If these two ethyl groups are present on same side, then that hexene is called as cis-3-hexene. And if they are on opposite side, then it is called as trans-3-hexene. One more example. Look at this compound. This compound, on this carbon atom, two different atoms are present. On this carbon atom, two different atoms are present. So this molecule will exhibit cis trans isomerism depending upon relative positions of this atom across carbon-carbon double bond. So in first case, these two chlorine atoms are present on same side of double bond. And in latter case, these two chlorine or two hydrogens are present on opposite side across this carbon-carbon double bond. So this is cis isomer and this one is trans isomer. In this way, alkenes shows cis and trans isomers. We can also observe cis trans isomerism in cyclic alkenes. Cyclic alkenes having ring size less than 7 always shows cis isomers. However, cyclic alkenes having ring size more than 8 or more than 8, they may show cis and trans isomerism. Let's have a look at one example. This is cyclohexene, and for cyclohexene one can draw these two different structures. In this case, this carbon-carbon double bond is having trans geometry, and in this case this carbon-carbon double bond is having cis geometry. If we write down cyclohexene in this format, that is in case of trans, then it is having extremely unstable structure because of this ring strain, and thus this structure is not possible. However, this cis isomer is highly stable. If you look at this example, cyclodecane, in case of cyclodecane, these two different structures are possible. Either this carbon-carbon double bond may have a cis geometry where both the groups are on similar side, and this type of trans geometry is also possible where the alkyl groups are present on opposite side to each other. So in this way, cyclic alkenes also shows cis trans isomerism. But do remember, if ring size is 7 or less than 7, then because of ring strain, such molecule do not show trans isomerism, and those molecule exist in cis form only. However, if ring size is greater than 8 membered, then in such cases this type of cis and trans isomerisms are possible in cyclic alkenes. Now we will see cis trans isomerism in cyclic alkenes. Cyclic alkenes having small ring size also shows cis trans isomerism. So we will pick some examples from cyclic alkane and the condition under which cyclic alkanes shows cis trans isomerism. In case of cyclic alkanes, rotation across carbon-carbon single bond is not possible, which leads to existence of cis trans isomerism in cycloalkanes. If two carbon atoms in cycle have common substituents, then cis trans isomerism is possible in case of cycloalkanes. For example, if you look at this molecule, this is 1,2 dimethyl cyclopentane. In case of 1,2 dimethyl cyclopentane, rotation across this carbon-carbon double bond is not possible, and thus it will not show conformational isomerism. But as the groups which are attached to these two carbon atoms are similar, these groups may have two different relative positions, and thus such molecules shows cis trans isomers. In this example, these two methyl groups are facing on same side, either away from the observer or towards the observer, and thus this molecule is cis molecule. And in this case, the relative position of these two methyl group is opposite to each other. One methyl group is moving away from the observer and another methyl group is pointing towards the observer, and thus they are having opposite position to each other. So this is cis isomer and this one is trans isomer. So if two carbon atoms in cyclic alkane are having common substituent on them, then depending upon relative position of that common substituents, cis and trans isomerism arises in cycloalkanes. Look at one more example. In this case, chlorine atoms are present on adjacent carbon atom in this cyclobutane ring, and this chlorine may have two different positions. Either these two chlorine are pointing towards the observer or pointing away from the observer. This is one possibility. And another possibility is, out of two chlorine, one is pointing away and another one is pointing towards the observer. So depending upon these relative positions of substituent, cis trans isomerism is possible in cycloalkanes. So this is cis isomer, where both the chlorines are on same side, and this is trans isomer, where these chlorine atoms are present on opposite to each other. These are different possibilities in alkenes, cycloalkenes and cycloalkanes. Now we will see certain limitations of this cis trans isomerism. If you look at this structure, in this structure, on this carbon atom, two similar atoms are there, and because of that, in this case, we cannot label it either as a cis or trans because of presence of these identical atoms on same carbon atom. So if identical atoms are present on same carbon atom, such molecule do not show cis trans isomerism. In the same way, if you look at this structure, in this structure, these identical groups and identical atoms are present on same carbon atom, and because of presence of these identical groups on same carbon atom, this molecule also do not show cis trans isomerism. So look at these examples. In this example, four different atoms or groups are attached across carbon-carbon double bond. And in this condition, we are not able to comment whether this molecule is a cis molecule or a trans molecule. However, if you look at these two molecules, you will find that molecular formula of both the molecule is exactly same. So they are isomers. The bond connectivity of both the molecule is exactly same. So they are stereoisomers. And the spatial arrangement of atom or group across this carbon-carbon double bond is different, but you cannot label them as cis or trans isomer. So these are certain limitations of cis trans isomerism. Now, in order to tackle with these limitations of cis trans isomers, we must need some other technique, some other methodology through which we can name these type of alkenes to overcome the confusion. And thus, there is another method which is used to name such type of alkene, and that method is called as EZ nomenclature. In next video lecture, we will explore the concept of EZ nomenclature. Because of all these limitations of cis trans isomerism, we required another system, which is nothing but EZ system of nomenclature for alkenes. I hope in this video lecture you understand what are cis trans isomerism, which are the different conditions in which cis trans isomerism is possible or not possible. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thanks a lot.